Legal marijuana linked to 66% rise in traffic deaths in Colorado. Marijuana and the vote to legalize it has been debated for years now. It's really pretty amazing where marijuana is legal these days. Currently in at least 8 states, which include California, Washington, Oregon, Nevada, Colorado, Alaska, Maine, Massachusetts, and the District of Columbia, you can now light one up legally. But are any of these states having significant issues because of the legalization of marijuana? In Colorado, statistics show that legalization of marijuana has been followed with an increase in traffic fatalities, emergency room stays, and crime. Others have argued that the legalized marijuana in Colorado has made it easier for drug traffickers to ship it across the rest of the nation. And the number of marijuana users has increased by 12%. On January 1, 2014, marijuana was legalized in Colorado. According to a report from the Rocky Mountain High Intensity Drug Trafficking Area, there are 491 stores selling it, compared to 392 Starbucks cafes and 208 McDonald's restaurants. Between 2013 and 2016, traffic accidents where marijuana was a factor increased by 66%. The overall increase in traffic fatalities was 16%. In 2016, there were 123 fatal accidents in which a driver tested positive for marijuana, over twice as many as in 2013. This accounts for 1 in 5 of all traffic fatalities in Colorado. Colorado also now has the highest youth marijuana consumption in the state, at a whopping 55% higher than the national average. College students smoke marijuana at a 16% higher rate, and marijuana usage increased by 71% for adult use, which is over twice as high as the national average. In 2011, hospital visits related to marijuana totaled 6,305. By 2014, they had reached 11,439. Between 2013 and 2016, crime increased in Colorado by 11%. In Denver, Colorado's largest city, it increased by 17%. Drugs being sent through the mail out of state increased eightfold between 2013 and 2017, and in 2016 alone, 346 vehicles were found to be taking the drug out of state. It was also found that marijuana dealers were shipping the drug out of state, also. One of the major promises by proponents of drug legalization is that it would increase tax revenue. However, this has not come to fruition. Only 0.8% of the budget was paid for by drug taxes. Colorado serves as an experimental lab for the nation to determine the impact of legalizing marijuana, the report read. This is an important opportunity to gather and examine meaningful data and identify trends. Citizens and policymakers may want to delay any decisions on this issue until there is sufficient and accurate data to make informed decisions. So much for all the vehement denials from the pro-legalize fanatics and their organizations that any harms have resulted from the legalization of cannabis, marijuana, in Colorado. How wrong have they been proved to be, said Mary Brett, chair of Cannabis Skunk Sense. How much longer will they be able to retain any shred of credibility? David Raines of the UK National Drug Prevention Alliance also warned of the dangers of legalization after seeing the report. The report from Colorado gives the lie to the claim that cannabis, marijuana, legalization in any society can be benign. The effects are profound, the social and personal damage extensive. The UK can learn from this experience, he said. Fortunately, despite the antics of a few, most MPs from the two major parties are wholeheartedly against any move to legalization in the UK. It's pretty amazing if you ask me. I mean, it's one thing to support medical use of marijuana, as 23 states do. It's another thing to support the recreational use of it. As you can see, in Colorado, over half of the state voted for the legalization of marijuana. Now they have over an increase in traffic accidents and an increase of at least 11% in crime. To think that 1 in 5 traffic accidents is caused by marijuana is pretty amazing. That would probably be similar to texting in other states. I'm all for medical marijuana being legalized in states, but when it comes to legalizing the recreational use of marijuana, that's a whole other ball game. We all know when the government gets involved in anything, it gets screwed up. Just look at our healthcare system. It's not a surprise really that a state like Colorado, with a mile-high stadium, would also have a mile-high shop that gets an award and gets recognized for selling marijuana. Until Colorado or any other state can convince me that they in fact have better control over public safety and have reduced crime, I don't support the recreational use or legalization of marijuana, other than for medical purposes. In addition, anytime you have marijuana businesses that are selling candy or products that kids like with marijuana in it, that is an extremely dangerous slope to be on. What's even more insane, language of marijuana and its use is now in the Colorado Constitution. Just think about the number of people in Colorado that are going to vote. If 55% of those in Colorado supported the legalization of recreational marijuana, how many of those same people do you think are voting with a clear head? Do more states really want to increase crime and traffic accidents due to legalizing recreational marijuana? Let us know what you think in the comments. Did you support the legalization of marijuana for recreational purposes and/or medical use?